breast lift, we have to understand that breast shapes can be different, and patients need individualized plans for optimal breast lift results. Operating on thousands of breasts has allowed us at Premium Care to refine our techniques for achieving consistently beautiful results. We evaluate each patient as an individual and listen closely to their concerns and goals. Then we apply our skills to each of our breast lift cases to attain the beautiful natural shape the patients are looking for with our breast lift surgery in Cartagena. Some of the key decisions we will make together include the technique and resulting scars, and whether to use or not an implant. Every person is different, and we will develop a plan that is right for you. The position and size of the areola are important considerations when we evaluate a patient for a breast lift. Typically, it's necessary to raise the nipple for a more youthful position. Often we make the areola smaller to achieve optimal proportions with the new tight and perky breast. For the patients thinking about having a breast lift, it's important to understand that breast lift surgery doesn't change the size of your breast or round out the upper part of your breast. If you want your breast to look fuller, you have to consider breast lift and breast augmentation surgery. If you want a smaller breast, you have to consider combining the breast lift and a breast reduction surgery. There are several key decisions that must be made in planning a breast lift. Breast shapes and patient goals are different. The surgical plan for a breast lift should be customized to the patient's particular body shape and also the desires. The best way to understand your options is by having a complete consultation with us here at Premium Care. At the moment of choosing the appropriate technique for you, that will be based on the breast size and shape, the size and position of your areolas, the degree of breast sagging, and the skin quality and elasticity, as well as the amount of extra skin. We have different techniques where we can choose from. First is the crescent lift that results in a semicircular scar that is going to be in the upper aspect of the areola. This lift may provide us up to 2 cm of elevation of the areola. It is best for small lifts or in cases where symmetry may be improved by adjusting one or both areolas. The second technique is the circumareolar lift that results in a scar that is camouflaged around the outer aspect of the areola, and it allows us to adjust the size and position of the areolas but doesn't provide much lift for the lower position of the breast. The third technique is the lollipop lift. This lift has a scar that is concealed around the circumference of the areola, as well as a vertical scar on the lower portion of the breast. This procedure gives us a significant amount of lift to the lower portion of the breast, as well as the nipple. It allows us to transform a droopy and boxy breast into a round and perky breast. And the fourth technique is the anchor lift. This lift will leave an inverted T scar that is essentially the lollipop with an additional incision underneath the breast. This procedure allows us to maximize the amount of lift and treat substantial droopiness of the breast. This technique is most common used for women who have a large amount of excess breast skin, typically after significant changes in breast size following breastfeeding or weight loss. The best way for the patients to understand their option is through a complete consultation with us at Premium Care. In our approach to breast lift, communicating with our patient is key. During the consultation, we will explain how the different procedures may apply to you specifically and what we recommend for your particular case. We will also be able to show the possible and expected result for each procedure option. For some patients, we may recommend that the breast lift is combined with a breast augmentation or a breast reduction. For us to best understand what you want, be prepared to discuss during the consultation why you want the surgery, your expectations and desired outcome, your general health status, and if you have pre-existing health conditions or risk factors. After we have understand what the patient wants, then we proceed to the examination. We consider many features including breast volume, width, height, nipple position, the areola size, the thorax curvatures, the skin tone, the droopiness, if there is asymmetry, and the crease position. Breasts are highly different, and we help the patient understand what their best options are on their physical characteristics. Before the breast lift surgery, we will ask you to get some labs or a medical evaluation if it's needed. You have to take certain medications or adjust your current medications. Also, we advise stop smoking well in advance of surgery. Avoid taking aspirin, anti-inflammatory drugs, and herbal supplements as they can increase the bleeding. We will also give you all the instructions about what to do on the day of the surgery, the use of anesthesia during your breast lift, the postoperative care, and the follow-up. We will also give you the prescription so you can get the medications that you have to buy and also the postoperative bra that we want you to use for at least 2 months after surgery. The breast lift procedure is done under general anesthesia. After a few hours in recovery, you're going to be ready to go to your accommodation. The recovery from a breast lift with us tends to be really easy because the surgery doesn't involve the underlying muscles, bones, or internal organs. After your breast lift procedure is completed, dressings and bandages will be applied to the incisions, and you will need to wear an elastic bandage or support bra to minimize the edema and support your breast as they heal. A small thin tube may be temporarily placed under the skin to drain any excess blood or fluid that may collect after the breast lift surgery. Although many factors are involved in your actual recovery time for breast lift, you will likely experience a post-surgical recovery period of 24 to 48 hours and an additional reduced activity period for a few weeks. You may experience mild soreness and edema for a few weeks, and exercise and normal activity can be resumed and the direction of your plastic surgery. Over time, post-surgical edema will decrease and the incision lines will fade.